All right, tell us what we're doing today.
So today I am packing a vintage schoolhouse globe lamp. It's quite large. It's got a long pole and a big globe. So we thought we'd show how we would pack something like that. It's quite large, you can see. So I've decided to pack both pieces in their own separate boxes and ship them. I think it'll be safer that way, and it'll just be easier to pack them that way. So this person paid $43 for shipping, so I'm pretty sure that's gonna cover the price for two boxes. I think it'll be okay. I'm pretty sure I do have a handling charge on it to cover insurance and packing materials, so I think there's gonna be a buffer to help cover all the extra costs of two boxes. So I'm going to pack the pole first. I happen to have the perfect box. It's a vacuum box because Jay bought a vacuum for us the other day. So it should work with I'll have padding here and then padding on the bottom, and it should be fine. I'm going to bubble wrap the pole, and then I'm going to use a bunch of scrap packing paper that we've got over the last few months to just keep it stable. This lamp is interesting because it actually has the original wiring, and there was a date on the lamp of 1913. So we know it's a genuine antique piece. It's not a reproduction. I think someone might have rewired this and this part, or maybe they just painted it. But it's definitely like this like metal, copper look that people actually pay a lot of money for lamps like that. New reproduction. So this is actually an original piece that's going to someone in Maine. So I'm sure they're matching their decoration or something like that. So I thought it was cool that it's an actual genuine vintage piece, especially because that globe is very delicate. I mean, it's a big glass globe, and for it to not have broken in 100 years is kind of amazing. Okay, so I'm going to pad out the bottom with paper, and then I'm going to fill in the rest around here with paper, too. So it should be good. Something's old. Okay, so I stuffed it full of paper, so it's nice and stable. When you shake it, it shouldn't move. It should just feel like a big pillow.
Okay, that's part one.
Part one, done. Because I'm putting it in two different boxes, I'm going to email the customer after I print the labels and tell them to expect two boxes. I guess the way I would explain that to them is just so that they're not worried about it, that it was two large pieces that were going to be better protected in two different boxes. So you want to assure your customer that you're professional and you know how to pack. And so I think that's what I'll do. I'll just say I really wanted to protect the pieces, so it's two separate boxes.
And are you going to number them?
Yeah. What I'll do is on the box, I will print out a piece of paper that says box 1 of 2, box 2 of 2. Just so it's very clear. And then I'll give them both the tracking numbers. eBay should give it to them, but I'm going to make sure that they have it in a message as well. So for the globe, you can see it's quite a large glass globe. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bubble wrap it. And then I'm going to put it in a box, which is its inner shell. And then I'm going to put it in a larger box with a lot of that paper padding so it floats in the middle. So I ordered this bubble wrap online through Amazon, actually. And they say it's actually biodegradable. So I don't know about that, but I try to get the biodegradable stuff as much as I can. I should do an experiment to see if it actually breaks down, but I buy 400 square feet at a time, so I get four of these at a time, and they last me, I would say, over 6 months, depending on how much I'm wrapping, but they last a long time. It's really important when you're selling delicate items like this big glass lamp to buy bubble wrap. For a long time, I did not buy bubble wrap because I was super cheap. And it's just essential for doing delicate stuff. You just have to invest in it. And I will put a link in the notes of this video of where I buy the bubble wrap. So I feel like this has been bubble wrapped quite sufficiently, and now it's going to go in the cardboard shell.
Have you ever had a floated item ever break?
Nope. I have never had an item that I use the floating method with break. I've never had damage to anything that I just put in a box with peanuts or just bubble wrap. I've had many things like that break, and I just learned my lesson after that. Okay, now that it's all bubble wrapped, we have a box that it'll fit in. I'm gonna actually pad out this box and then put this box in another box. So this is just paper that I've received in boxes of stuff that I've ordered. So I save that, or I'll use end rolls from the newspaper company. So once this runs out, I'll start using the end rolls. So this globe has an opening here to connect to the big pole, and I'm going to put that on the bottom because this is a very delicate piece of glass, and I think this is the more stable way to put it. So this is the first shell. Now I'm going to put it in a bigger box. This box I bought for $2.50 at Walmart. So it's a nice big moving box that we're going to put this other box in. When shipping this, this part is going to be the top. I'm going to say this end up. But the way I'm going to pack it is I'm going to flip this up and just pad it, put this in, pad the edges, and then flip it and put the label on the top, just because it's easier that way. So once this is in, I'm gonna start padding all around it and then on top here. I'm putting the packing slip in. It's the invoice and the packing slip. It's always good to have their address on a piece of paper on the inside, in case something happens to the label on the outside. Okay.
You did it!
That's the second box. I'm gonna put fragile labels and this end up arrows going to the top, and then I'll put their address label here. I'll tape over the address label so it doesn't get scratched or messed up. I would say that took max 30 minutes. So that's not bad. I didn't have to send it somewhere to have it packed for me and pay them, so that saved me some money. So we originally bought the lamp for $15 and it sold for $250. So that's quite a good price to get.
These are the two boxes with the lamps in them. Good job.